Dictators. The Zulu King Goodwill Zwelithini, who is the sole trustee of the Ingonyama Trust, that is the caretaker of vast tracts of land in KwaZulu-Natal, has objected, and some of his supporters have suggested this could lead to war. Well, to discuss, we're joined from our parliamentary studios by the Deputy Minister of Cooperative Governance and Traditional Affairs, Obed Bapela. Thank you for being with us, Deputy Minister. Could you explain briefly what is government's thinking right now on communal land? Like the Ingonyama Trust, some commentators say the law behind it is actually unconstitutional.
Thank you very much, Francis, and the viewers of SABC. We are engaging on the processes of meeting with the traditional leaders to have a mini summit, because at the time when the ANC had its own summit 2 weeks ago, they could not attend, and therefore we then concluded in that land summit, and also it was a conclusion at the NEC meeting this weekend, that a mini summit ought to be engaged so that all traditional leaders, or majority of them, and communities represented by their NGOs and other experts on land, and particularly those who are specialists in the rural land and also the communal land, will then be invited to that particular session so that we could then begin to engage on those issues that are obviously have been pointed out. One is the security of tenure for those people who are living in a communal land, the issues whether the permit to occupy is still relevant today, or there could be other systems that assure security of tenure. And on the issue of the Ingonyama Trust, we also had a discussion that the matter ought to be engaged, also raising the issues that the communities are raising, some traditional leaders also are raising, to then begin to engage with the Ingonyama, the king of the Zulus, Isilo Samabandla, and then say these are the issues that in a democratic South Africa people feel they are not okay with the setup as is. But I will not say the law is unconstitutional, because that was the law that was created as part of the new South Africa that we have now, we are now living in. And obviously, if there are issues in the democratic system that do not go well, every law is subjected to review, or amendments will then be instituted, but there should be proper discussion, proper engagement, and there is a delegation that the Minister of Culture, Dr. Zulu Mkhize, will be leading to go and meet with Ingonyama, the king of the Zulus, and to then begin to say, this is the process, the views that have been expressed are the views, we'll have to listen to them, we can't ignore them.
Deputy Minister, where is government leading? Could we see a repeal of the law that set up the Ingonyama Trust?
Well, depending on the investigations of the issues that have been raised by communities, some by traditional leaders, the validity of them, and also if they make any sense, and if indeed there are issues that are of important and significant, we'll definitely engage and then agree. And then once there's that particular engagement and agreement, there will be amendments or the review of the law. But obviously, we are not speaking repeal as yet. It's more going to be the review and the amendments to then bring in those things that communities are raising, those things that some traditionalists are raising, but also to also raise issues with the King of the Zulus, because he's the trustee of the land, currently as a custodian of the land that is under his custodianship.
Well, can this issue be resolved through a consultation with the king, who's unlikely to give up his rights, surely?
Well, the king is an accessible individual. He does listen, and obviously he will express his own views. And in the context of debate and discussions, I think we'll find each other. And I think we shouldn't be portraying the king as unreasonable. He is a very reasonable individual. But obviously the report, the way it was reported in the media, or how it came out from the Parliament High Panel, which was headed by the former president, Kgalema Motlanthe, obviously it created concerns and tension in the system. But the former president has explained that what he said was what was said by the people where he had gone to listen to them. But obviously there's a concern that most of the hearings by the high panel, they were more in the urban or semi-urban areas. They didn't go deep into the rural areas where those people who are living there should also have a voice. So when we engage on the issues, we must make sure therefore that we touch the soul and the heart of the people deep in the rural areas, the traditional leaders themselves, the kings of South Africa, so that we could then begin to come up with the harmonious areas that really needs intervention. And once those things have been identified, difficult as they may be, we may also end up having to agree on certain amendments where they are necessary. But if there's no any necessity of amendments, obviously, will be dictated to all by the views that have been expressed, both by the people, because the land in the communal land is owned by the people in the custodians of the traditional leadership. If the people are not happy with certain issues, obviously we ought to listen to the people and we cannot ignore those things. But the law is there to then protect them, and we'll then have to look at which amendments can then satisfy the needs of the people on the ground.
If you go to the actual people, the land should be administered in their interest, for their well-being, but it's emerged that they're being charged rent. They'll never have secure tenure and they're being charged rent. Is that right? Do you have an opinion, Deputy Minister?
Obviously, the issue of the security of tenure, the rights of the vulnerable groups, women and children, the right to inherit in a communal land, any properties that is left by the family, and also the right of women to own land, and also the right of women to inherit. Those are some of the issues that have been raised, and we'll have to look at them. We can no longer ignore them, because we live in a democratic South Africa that has a Bill of Rights that are universal to all South Africans. And obviously those issues, we did engage traditional leaders last year in the traditional Indaba, which was held by COCTA in Johannesburg at the Bedgewood, and they've also agreed that a system of security of tenure ought to be looked at. But what is it? Obviously, we have to do some bit of research, because there was those suggestions that said that we should have a title deed system. Traditional leaders did raise concern and say, if you give title deeds, people will then go and loan against their title deeds monies, and once they default, and then all the banks will then come in and then take over the properties, and we'll end up with Africans no longer having a land. Yeah. So we'll have to look at a variety of security of tenures that can be applied without the ownership right by the collective individual being compromised, because the 13% of the land belongs to the people under the custodian of traditional leadership. That system we are not going to be changing. It's the system that is recognized in the constitution. It's just the issue of the rights that are people are saying they are not as enough, and therefore we need to engage on those issues and then come to a conclusion.
But without a title deed, you cannot pass that land on to your children. You cannot go and get a mortgage bond and maybe use that money, maybe even use it as an asset to start a business with and back off that asset. Is government not working from that basis, that real land rights are important? They're important for the wealth of ordinary people and their futures.
But obviously, I mean, we are looking at various ownership systems. In the urban areas, people do have title deeds, and we'll continue with giving more and more Africans title deeds on the land that is in the cities, in the urban areas, in the towns. But in the rural areas, because the constitution does recognize both individual rights plus community and communal rights, so there are those communities that says we'll want to live this way, the African way, the communal way, and so that they could then continuously express their own cultures. But also land is being owned for ancestral purposes, there will be cultural and traditional issues. So we need to have those spaces in South Africa that we live in that still allows for this diversity of life, because the constitution said that we are united in our own diversities. But the system of the tenure, it's what we said, yes, we need to look at it. What is it? It will then depend on the talks. And then no title deed was but proposed. Others says land lease could be another option. But we'll have to widen up the debate and then get experts in who will then tell us what will be the best option that could still guarantee those rights of the individuals. We're not going to be undermining the right issue. We'll have to then deal with it, because now it has been raised.
So finally, could you comment on what the former president said, that the suggestion that tribal leaders are acting like tin pot dictators?
Well, the former president Kgalema Motlanthe did explain that what he said was what he picked up from the hearings as he was going around in that parliament high panel when they were listening to the voices of the people on the ground. And the tin pot village dictators came from those particular hearings. But obviously, it is what the people are saying on the ground. We'll have to investigate those issues. We'll have to look at them, why people will even describe certain traditional leaders as such. And then not all traditional leaders are bad, and I think we should not be casting them as if they are just the same. There will be a few of them probably that are doing things that are displeasing to their own people there. And once we have discovered who they are, what is happening, we'll have then to begin to look at regulations that can then regulate and protect the rights of the individual. Because traditional leaders are custodians of our cultures, custodians of the communal land. They have to do it in such a way that they do it in the satisfaction of the communities that they are representing, so that all South Africans can enjoy all their rights. And then obviously, if such incidences do happen, the traditional leaders will be engaged on them, and we'll have to identify who are those people, so that we could then bring some kind of certainty and a closure on this matter, so that traditional leaders are once more respected, because they also behave in a manner that is satisfactory to the people that they are representing and leading.
All right, thank you very much for your time this evening. That was the Deputy Minister of Cooperative Governance and Traditional Affairs, Obed Bapela. We take a